It seems like no matter what Mac you buy, you can never have enough SSD storage or ports. So in this video, we're going to take a look at the Satechi NVMe stand and hub for the Mac Mini and the Mac Studio. This will work with any Mac Mini up until the newest M4 Mac Mini, and it also works great with the Mac Studio. And if you look at this, you can tell Satechi did a great job designing this piece of hardware to look exactly like something Apple would design that seamlessly adds more ports to your Mac. Satechi did send me this hub for free for purposes of making this video, but they have no input into this content, and this is gonna be based on my opinions of this and my experience using this in the real world. So this was originally designed to work with the Mac Mini or the Mac Studio, and Satechi has had several versions of this over the years. This new one actually has a slot where you can put your own NVMe SSD in it, which really comes in handy for adding extra storage to your Mac. It'll give you speeds of up to 950 megabytes a second on the write side and 850 on the read side, which is pretty fast for archiving files or for doing some photo editing and video editing. It's not gonna be as fast as a Thunderbolt drive or the built-in drive to your Mac, but it's still more than enough for just keeping extra files on your computer. This does a great job at adding more ports and storage to your Mac Studio or your Mac Mini. Technically, it would work with the M4 Mac Mini, but it's gonna look kind of silly having the little computer on top of this. They also have a smaller version available for the M4 Mac Mini, but this is designed for the M1, the M2, or any of the other Mac Minis that have USB-C. You use one USB-C cable, and it just stays stored in the bottom of this. And then on the bottom of it, there's also the slot for the NVMe SSD, which is very easy to set up. All you have to do is insert the SSD at an angle, press it down, and then use the little screw and screwdriver to add it. And then you're gonna be able to have very fast storage that's built straight into it. On the front of the dock, you get an SD card slot, a micro SD slot, a headphone jack, 3 USB-A ports, and a USB-C port. So 2 of the USB-A ports come in at a speed of 5 gigabits a second, 1 of the USB-A ports supports 10 gigabits a second, and the USB-C port supports 10 gigabits a second as well. So this is gonna do a fantastic job at allowing you to plug SSDs into the front of it. Just note, none of those ports are gonna be Thunderbolt rated, so if you wanna get the Thunderbolt speeds on your computer, you still need to use the back ports. To set it up, all you have to do is set your computer on top of it, just line it up where it looks nice, and then plug the single USB-C cable in. There's no power supplies that are needed for this because it just uses the bus power from the computer. So this does a really great job at adding some useful ports to the front of your computer, which for the Mac Studio, this doesn't look quite as helpful as it was for the older Mac Minis, but there's still a couple reasons this is a great buy to go with a Mac Studio, namely just having the sleek storage built into it. And I also really appreciate having the headphone jack on the front of it because it's really annoying to reach around and plug your headphones into the back port by the power button, not to mention the fact that that just uses extra cord length and gets it even more out of the way. Also, I love having the USB-A ports and the C port on the front for plugging in flash drives, which the C port makes a little bit more sense on the Mac Minis that didn't have the C port on the front, but the USB-A ports are very handy for keeping a ton of different peripherals plugged in. I will say one bummer with this, the SD card slot and the micro SD card slot are only UHS-I, so they're not gonna support the faster UHS-II standard, which is okay. I just think that would have been a really nice touch, and their newer dock for the M4 Mac Mini does have that. So I really like this stand, and it adds a lot of versatility and convenience to your computer. The one thing I don't love about it is you lose one of your Thunderbolt ports. So depending on your workflow and the machine that you use it with, this may or may not be a problem for you. So before you get something like this, make sure you assess all the different peripherals you're using, the flash drives you're plugging in, and everything that stays plugged into your computer. Make sure you can spare one of the Thunderbolt ports to use this, because if you can't spare a Thunderbolt port, you may need to get something like a Thunderbolt dock or a Thunderbolt hub instead. Those do require an additional power supply, and they're typically a little bit bulkier. They don't look as nice as this, but they'll give you more flexibility with the additional Thunderbolt ports, just not in as sleek and convenient a way as the Satechi stand does. Some users have complained of Wi-Fi speeds with past versions of this stand, but I didn't notice any issues when using this with the Mac Studio. No Wi-Fi slowdowns for me. I feel like this is really designed for the Mac Mini more than for the Mac Studio, but I also think it's a really nice welcome addition for the Mac Studio for some users. So if you find yourself constantly needing USB-A ports on the front of your computer or also wanting an extra USB-C port, this is a great way to just use one Thunderbolt port on the back of your computer and to get more convenience. I also think it looks really nice. The color is just ever so slightly off from the Apple color. It looks a little bit lighter, but I'm also running a ton of bright lights in this room. But overall, this looks like something Apple designed, and it goes seamlessly with the Mac Mini and the Mac Studio. Comes in at $100, which I think is a reasonable price when you consider all the features you get with it. All the additional ports, the built-in SSD slot for it as well. It's just a great companion to your Mac Mini or Mac Studio. It's a way to add more life into those older Mac Minis that maybe are running out of storage, and also to give you the convenience of more ports and easier access to the ports on the front of it. If you're interested in buying the Satechi Mac Studio and Mac Mini stand and hub, I do have links to buy it in the description below. If you got any questions about this, leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear them. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content.